season kept going on, began to get better and better at mid and late game transitions and more comfortable, and it really began to showcase KT's weakness at those stages.
Yeah, a lot of people joke, you know, SKT broke KT, but I suppose in a sense, maybe they just exposed some of their weaknesses. Other teams have been catching up. So going into the pick and ban here for game one, everything looking normal so far.
Malzahar first ban by KT, followed up by Camille being first banned by Longzhu. KT now banning away the Talon from Fly. Longzhu responding with a Rumble Hover right now.
Yeah, these bans kind of explain themselves so far. KT definitely one of the teams that just continued playing Rumble until they forced it to be banned. Varus being banned here by KT.
And we'll see how Longzhu react with the final ban, if they will do Graves or not. If they don't do Graves, and they're highlighting Zyra, would be very surprised not to see him snatched up immediately. It's going over to KT, and highlighting Ashe.
And it's actually picked up right away. And you were talking about Graves, but not only Graves, but Nautilus is going to be hovered here by Longzhu. They may have just given two of the biggest power picks right away to Longzhu. Oh boy.
Well, Nautilus and Graves being locked in, so perhaps Score has something lined up. Otherwise, I don't feel like Graves is a champion. I feel like Graves is the only champion right now in the current meta that's in a tier of his own. He's basically in God tier, if you want to talk about S-class champions. No other jungler really matches up to him because he scales too well, he's too efficient, and he's just way too versatile. And KT now, they're going to lock in Lee Sin for Score, and that will give them a lot of aggression and some playmaking potential. And we'll see if KT actually stick to their guns of choosing three winning lanes and an extremely aggressive jungler to go with them, as that's basically been their motto for the season almost, where they look to really win laning phase really hard and then with the advantages just suffocate their opponents.
Yeah, and it looks like they're headed down that path right now. Longzhu definitely will have a chance to ban out some top counters to Nautilus, making that lane a little bit easier perhaps, as KT did elect to go for that Karma pick third.
Jin locked in for Longzhu, lots of scaling on their side so far, and now they're highlighting a Fizz. That would be targeted away at Smeb. Wouldn't be surprised to see a Shen ban as well, although that's not really something that you would attribute to KT, and KT now actually highlighting Kennen. So they're giving credit to Gorilla for being able to play the support Nautilus. And there's the Shen. Yeah, and it is banned away. KT now probably just want to target ban. And they're highlighting Ryze.
And it will be banned.
Away. Yep.
Yeah.
Probably means that Lulu or Nami will come out here for Longzhu right in this rotation, and that enables them to keep the counter pick for Fly.
Yeah, gonna leave that here for last, and so we will get a look at how KT wants to go into the top lane. And actually switching to Nami here with about 5 seconds left. If they decide to keep that, we'll see. And there it is, locked in.
Finally picked up, and now going over to KT. They're hovering Galio. This isn't 7.6.
Dev just being a troll for now. Swain. What else?
Talia. Well, that's a little bit more standard.
Yeah. There it is, locked in. That makes a lot more sense.
They need a champion that isn't going to walk into anything too dangerous. And now KT is their final pick, highlighting that Renekton for Smeb. So yet again, they have it.
Yeah.
Three powerful lanes backed up by an extremely aggressive jungle pick. And now Longzhu, their final pick, lock in Ahri.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen the Ahri being picked into Talia a lot, and today is not going to be any different, as Fly will be picking up that up. Another aggressive pick for flying the mid lane, although, again, he didn't look all too excited about that. Not that it looks like he gets too excited about much these days, but excited to see that lane.
Well, Longzhu's team composition, definitely very interesting, to say the least. The Ahri doesn't fit in quite as much as some other champions could have, but we'll see what Fly can do with it. They have a lot of scaling on their team composition, and KT, a little bit of a reliance on score and depth. The longer that the game goes on, they definitely want to win this really hard and really fast early on and transition smoothly. Otherwise, they're going to get caught in a little bit of a pickle that they've had in multiple other series this season.
Yeah, I mean, especially a bunch of the other losses that KT have been taking, I don't think anyone would be too surprised to see Longzhu putting up a pretty good fight against this team here.
This is the last look at the team comp before we jump into the game. Nautilus, Graves, Ahri, Jhin, and Nami. They definitely would have had an option to go for Lulu Orianna here, but they did opt out of it, and they grant themselves a little bit more aggression.
Mm-hmm. So let's see if they can turn that aggression into a win here going into game number one right now, KT versus Longzhu. Well, I think actually Longzhu won that one. Funny because KT generally has the most aggressive fans, although Afrika has been challenging that recently.
Let's be honest, no one has the Kongdu monster, Brendan.
Well, Kongdu does.
Yeah.
And I guess Samsung. But as you were saying, it seemed like he was just trying to jump ship a little bit onto a team that's doing a little bit better.
Kongdu did find themselves a little bit of an upswing towards the end. And so far in this game, no one really looking to take too many risks. It's important to pay attention to the jungler routes. If you're looking at score, you might expect that he could look to do something up in top lane. Interestingly enough, he could just do a Raptor red blue into a top gank, but on the other side, Crash, he could go for a little bit of a swing route where he does Raptor camp red golems top scuttle and then transition into his blue side jungle through mid. So there's definitely a lot of possibilities for both of these junglers early on, but I feel like score is only really going to find success up in top and bottom, at least until level 6 is involved.
One important thing to point out already in this game is that one of the small raptors was given over to Leah, so she's going to hit level 2 on this first wave. There it is. Just perhaps a little bit more safety against the Ahri early on, getting that pressure advantage.
And it looks like Crash just gonna actually transition immediately into his right side jungle. A little bit bizarre if he goes immediately over to blue. And the reason that I say this is because he has no gank potential in mid, and so he would be funneling in all of his resources onto bottom post-blue. That's a little bit of buff inefficiency if a gank wouldn't end up being successful. Even gets spotted out by that hawk shot, and so that's gonna deny him. So now he actually loses out on the ability to have previously just gone Wolf Camp and Grom.
Yeah, and I mean, we talked about this a lot before with Ashe. The hawk shot early on is just so unbelievably powerful, especially in the pro scene. And it makes a lot of sense to me now why KT did go for that Ashe. They wanted to take it away from Prey. And here comes Crash with that early gank. Mata might be in a bit of trouble. They're going immediately for him. The flash comes out, but the deadly flourish will land, and First Blood goes over to Crash very early on.
He found a crack in their armor. He managed to move around this because it wasn't protected by any wards from Pawn or Score earlier on. And so it was really key right there that they were able to find that gank. Otherwise, Crash was going to be super far behind Score. And it alleviated a lot of pressure down from that bottom lane. And that's really big because that's a lane that Score is going to look to later on.
Saw a ping there. It looks like Longzhu actually knows exactly where Score is with the ward. Probably saw some of the Krugs jumping around down here, as I don't think they've physically seen him, but they know. Got that information.
Meanwhile, in mid lane, nothing super bad happening, although Fly does seem to be getting a little bit of the worst end of the trade. He's also down a little bit in CS, but it's not the end of the world. But it's important to note that it's going to be unlikely that Crash is going to be able to make anything happen in that lane for Fly, who continues to actually take quite a beating.
Yeah, funny that he sticks around for the trade, too. He really wanted to get that cannon minion, but he took a little bit too much damage. He's going to be forced to be pushed out of this lane, and he's probably going to be losing more than he would have lost by just giving that up.
Crash is in pretty close proximity to it, though. He could just come to mid to pick up the wave, and he's certainly going to like that. Take another quick look at this replay here. So Mata ends up flashing away, and interestingly, right there, Crash ended up getting the kill thanks in part to the red buff, and that was a really clutch deadly flourish hit by Prey. Now heading back into live, Smeb a little bit too far up.
Oh boy, and this dredge line will land. Smeb, he knows that Crash is coming from behind. Able to get that stun onto Expression, the double dash, so he will get out of here.
They know that he just planted a ward, though, so it does open up the possibility for Crash to try to move around that, perhaps go to Baron Pit, slide through with his E. But instead, choosing not to do that, immediately pathing down to the bottom half of the map.
Ooh, taking a look up here at top Expression, taking a lot of damage. He still does have that teleport. Looks like he will look to use it now. But down a level to Smeb up in top. You can see that CS gap widening. Already over 20. He should be able to pick up some of that wave, though, as he comes into the turret.
And right now, bottom lane under quite a lot of pressure, although Prey did itemize into the tier 2 boots immediately. Gonna have a little bit of mobility in his favor. Both junglers now, though, on the bottom half of the map might end up running into each other depending on what route Score takes.
Well, he just cleared out a ward, and you can see that he's coming back. Score is, so he's looking to be a little bit cheeky up here. Will be scouted out, and actually Expression making his way towards mid. See if they can pull off this gank. He's coming down, but actually they're looking to collapse onto Score here, who may be forced to flash this Dragon Pit wall, or actually just jump over once that cooldown comes back up. Just trying to wait for it. And there it is. Finally, he does jump the wall.
Takes quite a lot of damage for that, though. He's at about half HP. He's definitely going to be able to go back up to full, though, using Smite and some lifesteal. So right now, KT, you can see from the gold, they have quite some advantages across the lanes in the jungle matchup, even though Crash was able to get that first blood, not really that far ahead in terms of gold.
Yep, not quite. Score has been keeping up quite nicely with that CS advantage that he does have. So outside of this bot lane, which looks pretty even, all the lanes going very well. And speaking of bot lane, just as I'm saying it, Mata eating a lot of damage. You can see Gorilla's pretty low as well. So just trading a bit back and forth.
On getting nice little trade-off. Fly getting quite bullied in this mid lane this so far this game. Already down 14 CS. We're not even at 10 minutes yet.
Seems like he's just been struggling to keep up with that never-ending push that Pawn is doing. And you can see he went double Doran's. He has that extra mana regen, but he's still struggling to keep up. And we've seen some of the trades in the mid lane. They have not been looking too good. KT able to even come into the blue buff as they knew Fly had to recall and pick that up.
The other thing that's important that you just mentioned is that Fly went for the double door runs and didn't really find too much success with it. So later on down the line, I mean, that's going to be extra gold for KT in a sense that they didn't have to invest into. Certainly didn't pay off. Now it looks like Pawn actually might just itemize Abyssal Scepter, first item, whereas Fly picks up the Lost Chapter, so likely to go into Morellon Omicron. Crash trying to establish some vision right now for his team. But because his bottom lane just reset, and the enemy bottom lane did, it's not like there's any sort of dragon opportunity available right now.
Man, look at that. They just walked over a ward, both Gorilla and Crash. So their gambit did not pay off. Going to have to head back to bot lane. Crash is sticking around there. Looks like he's just going to go to his Gromp.
Score trying to move in. He doesn't know about that ward, though. So he's trying to be a little bit sneaky here, make something happen. It's definitely difficult in mid. And they're looking for an Infernal Drake timing, and it doesn't look like there might be any sort of way for Longzhu to stop this.
I think they're just going to be a little bit too late, although Crash is coming on in. This will be taken. Depth being knocked up. So much being used onto him. That third bullet will be enough to take him out, but here comes Pawn on the get-go. Able to pick up Crash, now jumping out to Prey. What just happened there? Down in Bouncy Town, able to pick up a double kill here is Pawn. And KT easily able to turn that one around.
And Expression didn't even teleport down. Though I wasn't totally paying attention to where he was on the minimap. Maybe he wasn't able to. And now Pawn actually looking for a kill in mid lane, but just going to force Fly out instead. They also picked up the Infernal Drake. So, nonetheless, it's going to be a huge victory across the board.
Oh, he might take that brush. Oh, man. Fly even losing that recall timing. Nothing going right this time for Longzhu.
He's going to lose out on this wave in mid, but Expression trying to get there. And instead just turns around. They're going to actually give it to Crash. Gold would be a little bit more efficient on him probably at this stage. And yet again, we can see the gold discrepancies between everyone. 1,300 gold in the mid lane. I'm going to take a look at this replay here. Deft ends up getting hit by the bubble from Gorilla. Crash putting out enormous amounts of damage. Then Score decides doesn't want a body block for his teammate. So that curtain call from Prey able to get the final kill. And then this is Bouncy Town right
there. That is so funny. The knockup from Pawn.
So really well executed by KT. They managed to win that fight.
Yeah.
They still have teleport, though, on Expression, which maybe could come into play if they can find an opening for it. But as long as KT acknowledged that, okay.
Oh, well, speaking of finding an opening, standing on a ward is Crash. He's going to pay for it and Fly forced to flash away. And now he gets hit by the Enchanted Crystal Arrow. That's going to be another kill, finishing him off with the kick for good measure, as KT are beginning to run away with this one.
Yeah, they are busting this game wide open right now. 3,000 gold lead at 12 and a half minutes with an Infernal Drake. And now the bottom lane for Longzhu under tons of pressure as they're forced to just sit at their turret. KT getting tons of turret damage down. Smeb is proxying waves.
Yeah, and this is what you were talking about. You know, KT, they get ahead early, and they run with it. So if Longzhu cannot come back in this game somehow, some way, I think they're going to be in a lot of trouble. As KT, they've opened themselves up a really nice lead, the one Infernal Drake, and the second one coming up next, which KT should have control over. Things are looking pretty good.
Taking a look at this replay. Crash, unaware he was on top of a ward. Really easy cleanup. And then right here, the Chanted Crystal Arrow connecting with Fly. You look at that duration on it. No chance Score picking up that kill right at the very end. Fly, a little bit of mechanical error just now in live. But if this game keeps going the way that it is, it's going to be extremely unlikely that Longzhu are going to be able to make it out of the mid game with their mid laner being as far behind as he is and not much resources up in top lane. It's going to be near impossible.
Yeah, look at this. Perfectly set up there by Score. Expression had no idea. No wards to spot. The two of them coming up top. That's going to be the first turret going over to KT as well.
Split the gold a little bit, and now with Smeb and Score up in top lane, that actually could have pressed on to the next turret, but instead opting out of it. So they're showing that they want to get out onto the map and do something else. They might go for a Rift Herald right
Looks
here.
Looks like it.
Yep. Okay, so that's what they want to do. So they had two options available. Because they know that Expression has teleport and that it's impossible for Crash or Fly to go up to the top half of the map, they could have looked to get a lot of turret damage down. Instead, they're opting into a more macro play and getting that Rift Herald.
Fly just showcasing a bit more of his domination, or rather Pawn, his domination of Fly in this lane. Pawn currently at 100% kill participation right now, 3-0-3 for the 6 kills that KT has.
Gonna pick up that blue buff right now. He's been having a fantastic game. Hitting that 10 CS a minute mark, 3-0-3. And definitely just doing so much work for his team. And it looks like Score is not quite done with Expression yet.
He wants another piece. He wants to go down under. Here we go again. And the kick onto Expression. He will be knocked up. A Pawn is here too. Sorry, buddy. You're on your way out. Down he does go. Kill is going to be picked up there by Smeb.
And giving that kill to Smeb is only going to further accelerate him ahead, rather than put it on Pawn at this point, because any kills that go on to Pawn is almost just excessive. He's going to be doing the same exact thing for the most part inside of the team fights. He's going to be more poke and control oriented, and him getting an extra recipe for an item component is not going to change too much, but the quicker that Smeb can accelerate into his other items means that there's that much more threat inside of the split push, and that's infinitely more valuable.
Yeah, very true. Look at this setup here. Fly. He does not have a Spirit Rush available or his Flash. Oh, the Flash coming in from Smeb, and he does get close enough to land that stun. Score going to pick up the kill this time.
And what seems to be KT versus Dynamic Q here in game number one continues to get everything blown open.
Deft is trying to go 1v2 right now. All just going to throw that out there. And he's putting on the pressure for his team to rotate down bot too. Score looking for the kick. Lands that Sonic Wave. And that might just be a couple more kills. Prey easily going to be going down. Pawn on the chase here for Gorilla. The exhaust is not going to be enough to keep him back. And two more kills picked up for KT.
Just want to point out that Crash is doing Gromp right now.
Yeah.
Not that he could do anything else, but as Gorilla went down, it was funny to see him just start the Gromp camp. Right now, the game just feels completely unsalvageable for Longzhu. A second Infernal Drake is going to go over to KT. Crash trying to set up to kill Deft. He might just go for it with the Flash.
Well, he gets that slowdown. Deft actually turns onto him, has that heal available. Here comes Fly, teleport coming on in. And trying to come down here with the wall now is Pawn. Smeb getting on top of Fly, but he does have that Spirit Rush available. Going to look for the kill here now onto Expression. Charm does miss Smeb, but a nice knock up here with the bubble. Smeb getting a little bit low, and they will successfully disengage. Here comes the curtain call. Just got a block for Smeb. Doesn't look like any curving bullets are going to happen this time.
That was a nice little pickup for Longzhu right there. Crash able to patiently wait, doesn't even have to expend his Flash in order to make that kill work. Smeb came in via the teleport, but came up short in the end. Now KT coming fresh off of a recall, though. You can see the items now that they just picked up for themselves across the board. Definitely going to turn their attention towards mid lane. You can see the way that they're moving out of their base. They're putting their bot into mid. Jungler goes over to his red. And Pawn's going to go up in top lane. We'll take another quick replay of this. So you see the teleport coming in from the bottom from Expession. And Deft was trying to go 1v1 against Crash. Fly ended up showing up and ruining the party. And when Smeb showed up, initially he goes on to Fly, almost was able to get him, but not quite. And then because of that, they're not able to get Expression in the end, who's able to dredge line away. So Longzhu finding themselves with at least a kill, but they're down almost 10,000 gold here at 19 minutes in double Infernal Drake.
Yeah. So add another nice chunk of gold, you can call it, just in the amount of stats that they will pick up. So here's that mid push you were talking about. A ping did go down onto that ward in the back, but there is no teleport available, so can't really make any use of that. Not sure if they would really want to engage on the map right now against KT.
Smeb now in split push mode. He's sitting on top of a ward right now. He doesn't quite know it. Gorilla playing dumb. And Smeb ends up backing up and getting away. But the lane allocation that they have right now, the 1-3-1, this is going to be the strongest that they can coordinate with now. Although with Baron coming up in 10 seconds, they might just go for a 4-0-1. Keep Smeb in bottom lane despite him not having teleport. He's still way too much of a threat. Score tells Mata he doesn't like how he looks today. Knocks him into the Baron pit.
And it was looking like maybe they were going to head towards that Baron, but nothing doing so far. Just hanging around. Didn't really see this as what the stronger teams will do, is make sure that they get vision in the red side jungle first if they're playing for the blue side. And just look to get picks before going into the Baron. But it seems like they're actually going to rotate down here towards mid, or rather bot, as this wave is pushing on in.
And here comes the Weaver's Wall. Expression, you have nowhere to go.
Yeah, and he doesn't have that flash either, so. Curtain Call is opened up here. They're trying to land some stuff onto Mata, who will eat a bunch of damage, but it doesn't seem like it's quite enough to open up a kill.
Now KT just posturing, though, around this bottom turret. Meanwhile, fly off in top lane. Pushing that lane in. It's likely that he's going to be able to at least raise top tier one turret. You can see he was going to recall, but then he stops and he proceeds anyways. You can see that all of KT is still in bottom lane. He knows that, okay, I can't get to bottom to change any of the result happening there. Let me just push the wave in because I know that they can't just magically teleport top and kill me.
Oh man, they were trying to set up something here as the wave was going bot, but everybody on KT is spotted by a blue trinket ward. So Baron's still available. You can see Score is heading up top to clear up that big wave that Fly just pushed in. And let's see where KT wants to head from here after taking down that bottom tier two.
Score trying to just pick up as much gold as he possibly can. And also, interesting to point out his itemization path. He has the Warrior Enchant with the Black Cleaver. A little bit surprised to see that he doesn't just go into like a Hex Drinker as well. Further make use of that Infernal Drake. Well, it looks like he is going into Dead Man's Plate next. Seeing the gold differences between everyone yet again. 3,000 in bottom lane.
3,000 in bottom lane, 3,000 in mid lane, too. Score and Smeb obviously ahead.
I meant 3,000 in mid lane.
Oh, okay, there you
no,
go.
Yeah, I'm
I think it actually did add up to 3,000 in bot lane in total, too. So you weren't off. It was close, at least.
And right now, you can see that Longzhu, if you look at their itemization, they're still waiting on their second core items across the board. And so there's a timing window that KT can hit, where Longzhu is still vulnerable to any sort of pushes or sieges. And if KT would actually just go for a Baron bait, in the sense that they start the Baron, but they don't really have intent to take it, they can force Longzhu to come to them and then try to collapse onto them and kill them. And there would be no way for Longzhu not to try to walk into that. But they do get themselves a little bit of breathing room in the sense that Ocean Drake came up. KT definitely not going to be the most positive team to take that.
You can see what they're trying to set up here. The arrow goes wide, actually. They will set up the wall and force a flash out of Gorilla. But can Smeb collapse in time onto Prey? No, he's going to use the blasting plant to get away. And so a couple of ultimate abilities used here by KT, but no kills picked up.
They're going to turn their attention to the Ocean Drake. They want to get this off the map as fast as possible. As unless you basically have Baron buff and you're constantly pushing and sieging, outside of that, it doesn't really have much use at this stage of the game. Looks like the next dragon that's going to spawn is Mountain, which they're definitely going to love.
Yeah, it's going to make rushing down the Baron pretty strong. Also, baiting out the Baron, as you were mentioning before. So we'll see what KT wants to do. Are they just going to wait for that arrow cooldown to come back up and play it safe? I think with the lead that they've gotten, they could probably be playing a little bit more aggressive. But with all of the shortcomings that they've had in the past couple of weeks, I don't blame them for just trying to take it a bit slower and play a pretty solid macro game here in the mid-game.
It looks like Score was looking for something on Prey. Not going to be able to find it, though. Got the Yumu's act out of him, but that doesn't really matter with how short of a cooldown it is. And what we're actually seeing unfold right now is the typical KT where they absolutely obliterate their opponents in the early stages of the game, and then the game stagnates. And yes, they're still securing themselves advantages and leads. They picked up the Ocean Drake. They still have map control, but with a 10,000, almost 11,000 gold advantage, they're not doing anything with it. And this is the stage of the game where it becomes more complex. It's more difficult to understand the macro moves that you can use to fork your opponent or force them into fighting you, not even, you know, being a fork. They're going to pick up Fly here, or at least try to.
Yeah, they burn his flash and his ultimate, but that is about it. And you were talking about that stagnation. It's because they refuse to go for any of those macro moves you were talking about, but also they don't want to go for any big objectives unless they can get a pick first. So they're just sitting here waiting for a pick over and over, and they're opening up opportunities for Longzhu to get picks just like this. Doesn't look like it's going to work out, though. Crash getting very low, forced to flash away from the arrow. And actually, it hits Fly up at top. Didn't even see that one. Smeb comes in, picks up the kill. The whole audience is like silent as nobody realized what was going on, and then people began to realize, especially now locked up by that wall, the damage coming out of depth here. He's forced to flash now. Smith trying to go on in 1v3, taking a bit of damage. Prey actually turns around and picks up a kill here, but will eventually go down as he did not have any summoners. So trading one for one now, it is four members of KT to the three left over of Longzhu.
Well, that was the most unintended successful arrow in the entire world that started this whole thing. Crash might go down.
Oh, they pick up that kill. Pretty clean, too. Smeb forced to use his flash for it, but they do get the kill and the turret.
See another replay of that fight, I'm sure, in coming moments. They get that turret. They're going to back off now. They have a ton of on-field gold. So even though they have a 13k gold advantage, if they're all pooling 2k gold apiece, that's not really 13k advantage when Longzhu just came fresh off of Fountain. And Smeb might not be done yet, though. He's going to continue to push in a wave. And this is actually the stage of the game where the next item for Score and Smeb should be Guardian Angel both. We'll take another quick look at this fight. So it looks like Crash was actually going to be able to take down Mata, then the exhaust came out, they cast the redemption, the arrow goes wide, but lands on Fly.
Nothing is going right for Fly this at the end of this season, man. Poor guy.
He's getting Fly swatted this game. Weaver's Wall came out right at the end, and replay cuts off there, but we all know what happened next.
They all wanted to see just one thing, the arrow onto Fly. To add insult to injury. Let's see what KT decides to do from here, because they got another objective. They add to their gold lead. You can see Longzhu's just waiting for Pawn to come on in and try to clear the ward, but who was smarter than that? Did see, I think it was Fly waiting there with a ward of his own.
I right here, what they could even do is you could just put Pawn with Smeb and have them dual push a lane, so you go for a 0-3-2 or a 3-0-2.
Looks like it might happen again here. The Tidal Wave comes out, Spirit Rush. The arrow is actually going to hit Gorilla here in the front, so he will go down. Death, he wants to go on in. Big burst it down, and he will actually eat that damage from the Ahri. Now Curtain Call opened on up. First two shots will miss. And everybody from KT will get out alive. Meanwhile, Smeb is in the mid lane pushing it down.
Smeb is going to get that mid lane turret. Now the inhibitor is exposed. Crash have to be so careful here against Pawn and Smeb. He gets locked up. Pawn can definitely chain and get the kill onto him. They're going to get the inhibitor and possibly just turn their attention towards capturing that Mountain Drake. Blue also going to likely be stolen away.
So funny to watch KT play in this situation, because compared to other teams like Kongdu, who will just start Baron at 20 minutes even when they're behind, KT's like, no, we're not going to even go close to the Baron until we at least get an inhibitor. We didn't pick up any Mountain Drakes this game, so no, it's just not going to happen. And you can see they haven't even touched it so far.
Gold discrepancy now continuing to widen across all the lanes. 15k gold advantage here at 30 minutes.
Not a single turret taken by Longzhu either. It's just been pressure right from the get-go, just as you were talking about. Looks like they're going to leave Score to pick this up alone.
They're going to be able to do that relatively easily. Still, though, a little bit surprising with their itemization. Smeb and Score could have definitely just both gone Guardian Angel, and that opens up the ability to dive turrets that much easier. But now with this Mountain Drake, they're going to be able to shred through Baron so quickly. And that's going to be their next objective that they're going to have to look to capture. Fly finally able to find himself a victory in the game. He was able to kill that ward. He said to it, "It takes as many hits as I have deaths to remove you from the map." So he was feeling ecstatic just now.
Fighting back.
And taking a look at this replay, Score went in, kicks Fly away. Deft maybe having a little bit of a hesitation on the arrow right there, coming out a little late, and then he's just going to him. The only way to really say anything about that is it almost looks like tilt, that they're frustrated, that they must know exactly how far ahead they are, and yet nothing's happening. So Deft was trying to take matters into his own hands, but it ended up backfiring. But through that, Smeb was able to open up the inhibitor. So it wasn't a total loss.
Score being locked up here. I just don't think they have enough damage to lock him down. He's going to jump that wall. And the Weaver's wall kind of just sailing on through. Oh, nice knock up here, preventing Smith from dodging away. Looks like he might still get away, even burning his flash. Not sure if he had to do that, but he will survive. And are they actually, I mean, there's pings going down here onto the Baron. Looks like maybe they just wanted to clear out a ward. And finally, they're beginning to beat Baron here at 32 minutes into the game. Trying to get a knock up onto Fly. The arrow hits Prey this time. So many times this is going to happen. And Prey will actually go down because of that arrow. Still on the chase here. The flash forward with the exhaust trying to take down Fly, who doesn't have any summoners. And down he will go. Now slowing down Crash here. Here comes Smeb, going to land that stun. We'll take out a third member of Longzhu on the chase.
Yeah, and KT, they're not even going to need Baron at this point. The death timer is way too high, especially in Gorilla. Not going to be able to stop this push. And that's going to be it for game number one here, as KT completely eviscerate Longzhu.
Oh boy. Pawn just stacking on extra kills to that KDA. This entire team wants to do it at this point. But it looks like that's going to be it. Game number one will go over to KT in about 33 minutes.
And that was the type of game that KT is so known for in a way. They get super aggressive lanes. They set it up perfectly. Score moves around the map. He does his thing. And they get advantages, and then they get more advantages. And it keeps piling up. But then the game hits the stagnation period where KT don't look like they know what to do with all their leads. And so sometimes the game ends up actually backfiring and their leads end up disappearing and the enemy teams recover. But in this case, they were able to finally close it out. And a huge component of that was Pawn and Smeb just applied so much pressure around the map.
You can see that the faces of Longzhu, they didn't even look all that sad or angry about it. There's just like smiles of embarrassment. That might be the happiest I've seen fly all season, man. Like, I don't know. It seems like he's not so happy about his performance against Pawn there in the mid lane.
And it looks like the coach not even that mad. Almost like, you know, what can you do? There's nothing really to say. Sometimes players just have bad games, and
yeah,
that's looking like what it was. He didn't really lose mid lane because of any sort of jungler interaction. He lost it on his own.
Yeah.
So it's okay. Sometimes that happens, but we're going to go to the analyst desk.
Yeah, we're
going to game number two.